See, I tried to tell y'all about Manscaped a while ago, but you didn't listen. This stopped being about nuts a long time ago. Manscaped is for your overall grooming experience, for your overall hygiene experience. Now, we have the Beard Hedger Pro Kit. You can look all up in this little box right here that Manscaped provided for me, and you'd be like, well, Voch, if this is supposed to be a top-tier beard trimmer, where's all the guards, Voch? How do I adjust the length for my beard? Let me tell you something, man. Manscaped is pushing the envelope. They have an internal beard length adjustment trimmer. This has 20 different notches on it for 20 different length. And just look, come on, bro, that's 20 different notches. So whether you got a beard like me or a beard like Law Nation, we got something for you. Easy to clean. You pop this thing right off, clean it up, pop it right back on, and it is waterproof anyway, so it shouldn't be getting super duper dirty anyway. Inside of this kit, man, we have beard conditioner, beard balm, we have a beard shampoo, and a beard oil. One day my beard is gonna get thick enough to use some beard oil, but you get a free gift that comes with this package. You get a beard brush, a beard comb, and beard scissors. So when you do have that big thick long beard, you just want to make those small adjustments, right? Manscaped sends you some beard scissors on the house. You can't beat this deal with a stick. So listen, man, go get you one of these, man. Use promo code VOCH20 for 20% off and free shipping, and they ship internationally. Listen, man, it's normally your balls will thank you, but we got beard trimmers, so now your beard will thank you, your face will thank you. We're gonna stick with beard. Your beard will thank you. And we back to that. I wanted to break down a little bit of Stephon Gilmore, just a little bit of his debut versus the New York Giants, our cornerback to Stephon Gilmore. There were some Cowboy fans that was worried about his athleticism, him being older. Is he going to go backwards a little bit? I don't think Gilmore's going to win all that much with athleticism. Pardon me. I think he's going to win mostly with IQ and patience and things of that nature. But I also think, you know, him being savvy, smart cornerback guy working in tandem with this pass rush, that's what's going to be. That's where he's going to get a bunch of his wins. Right now, one more thing I want to talk about is the type of opponent that Gilmore is going to be going against. I think the only type of receiver that can whoop Gilmore right now is you got to be a nuanced type route runner, and you got to be super athletic. If you're just going to be regular athlete dude and you're not doing anything to throw Gilmore off at the top of your routes or anything like that, then the target's been identified. You are as good as got. Take a look at this play down bottom here. We're going to run it, then we're going to come back and talk about it a little bit. And basically, this shows you exactly what I was just talking about. Gilmore identifying the route. Let me tell you the exact part when I realized Gilmore identified the route. He's a man, by the way. So now he's on the outside hip of this wide receiver. Why? Because he's kind of supposed to be, right? But when you see Gilmore kind of drift to the inside hip here, that is all the identification that we need here. Why? Because we just know what the route is. There's no way that this is going to be a deep cross corner or anything like that. It's one, the pass rush won't allow that, and that's just not what this offense does, right? Gilmore is going to switch to the inside leverage, and what I love about this, right, is at this point we're not worried about the wide receiver very, very much anymore. The route is the route, which also goes into the pass rush conversation, right? The route at this point is the route. So once Gilmore works to the inside leverage, now he's going to get eyes on Daniel Jones. And this is where a more savvy cornerback dude comes into, because now we're not playing receiver. We're just going to go find the ball in the air. And when Daniel Jones throws the ball, pardon me, when Daniel Jones throws the ball, Gilmore just simply makes a play on that football. That's going to lead to a lot of picks later on in the year, but we'll have that conversation later on. But like I said, this pass rush, if I'm Stephon Gilmore, let me just take you through the mindset. Hey, 9 times out of 10, the first route that you show me, that route is 9 times out of 10 going to be the route, because this pass rush is doing stuff like this. Whether it's a sack or not, Micah Parsons is out there existing. Sam Williams is out there existing. Chauncey and Neville Gallimore are somehow getting pass rush here, right? So there's not going to be a whole bunch of double moves that, you know, they used to get Trey Diggs on last year. I don't think they're going to get Trey on those regardless. But it takes a lot of time for you to get those, right? Take a look at this, chat. Let's see. 5 offensive linemen, Saquon Barkley, and a tight end. That's 7 guys protecting 5. 7 guys trying to block 5, and we're still getting pressure here. Fantastic job. Same concept right here, right? Let's talk about it. Gilmore working versus, well, whoever cares what this receiver is. But hey, you're not going to do anything to throw Gilmore off of his mark, right? You're not going to set anything up at the top of the route. So we're just going to run this thing straight up. And it comes down to, hey, Gilly, when you identify, that's when you go make your play on top of the pass rush, giving way less time to Daniel Jones to make the throw. What I love about Gilmore here is his leverage. Once again, you've heard me say that word again, leverage. Football is all about leverage. That's the first thing that they teach us in football school. But leverage can be used in many different ways. In this particular situation, top of the route. Let's go to the breakdown. Bop, 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 top of the route. Cool. This is what Gilmore, this is where Gilmore is right now, right? He is keeping himself safe, protecting himself, whether it's an outside or a route working outside or a route working inside. If this wide receiver works inside, he's going to have to go through Gilly. If this is a dig or like a post or something like that, then you're going to have to run into Gilly, and Gilly's going to feel you going towards him, right? And then he'll just be able to turn his hips and run. But hey, if you're just going to continue to work outside, whenever you break down, I break down. That's in Gilly's mind. When you break down, I break down. Boom. Now, in any other situation, if this was a team with a more inferior pass rush, could there have been the possibility for more moves? Sure. But how this pass rush works into Gilly doesn't have to cover for 7 seconds or 5 seconds or anything like that. This is a 1,000-1,002 situation. And what I love about when Daniel Jones moves in one direction, and Jalen Hurts is going to be another guy like this, and Josh Allen is going to be another guy like this, if you love to run and you work in one direction, Gilmore identifies that. And once Gilmore sees you running to the right side of the field towards him, the left side of the field doesn't matter. He's not going to throw the ball to the left side because you're running towards the right. So once Gilmore sees you coming his direction, that's another advantage for him. Play the football. Now, let's take all the lessons we've just learned and let's put them all together. This is Gilmore up top. He's going to be covering Darren Waller. And just like I said, Darren is not going to be doing very much from a route running standpoint to throw Gilly off of his mark. That's not going to be a thing. We understand the leverage game. If we're going to be, I don't even know if this man coverage or not, boom, boom, boom. Now, this is more zone coverage. Gilly lined up on the inside leverage. But anyway, hey, if it's zone coverage, that's even better. That means Gilly gets to work more eyes on Daniel Jones, if anything. Just another thing too, Gilmore's patience, right? Just as an old veteran savvy high IQ corner, his patience right here, right? He has the ability, something else he has the ability to do is to take his eyes off of the quarterback and put it on the receiver back to the quarterback, right? I'm looking at Waller to make sure I know where he's at. I'm looking at Daniel Jones just so I can make sure I know where he's at, right? And the same two things happen on this play that happened on the last play, right? We're going to get some pressure that's going to cut down on the time to throw. That's going to cut down on the amount of time that I have to actually cover Darren Waller. But then again, Daniel Jones is scrambling. So if you're going to work to the right side, then only Gilmore and J'Ron Curse are involved, right? They should know. Gilmore in his mind, Curse in his mind should go, all right, Daniel is going my way. We're cutting the field in half. It's got to be coming towards me. Let's get my eyes on Daniel Jones. And if you look at Gilmore, after he takes his eyes off of Waller here, he gets his eyes on Daniel Jones and he makes the pick, man. Go get the football. Go get the football so we can lead the league in takeaways again. Hey, I ain't want to hold y'all too long, man. Just wanted to break down another little film session. The debut as a Cowboy, Stephon Gilmore. Fantastic to have him. And this is not going to be a team where you can just get beat up everywhere else and just try to throw deep balls versus cornerback two. Cornerback two is actually dangerous. All right. Appreciate you, Manscaped. Y'all hold down for the Doski Wilson. Peace, Kweeski. Until next time. Salute.